Steven Spielberg is an executive producer, one of the distinguished executive producers, knows something about dinosaurs. We see dinosaurs covered in the series, but you are taking on really life from the cellular level at the origins of life and through today. I mean, tell me about this extraordinary challenge from a visual effects point of view of what you've pulled off.
Yeah, it's a big story, isn't it?
It's the best
story.
It's even worse when you've got Steven Spielberg as your executive producer if you're me making dinosaurs. But yeah, I mean, it's just the incredible scope of telling the biggest story there is, which is the history of how we got to today from the very beginning. And obviously incredibly challenging, the amount of life that's been and gone, you know, 90% of it, 99% of it is gone. And all we have is some bones to build all those creatures from. And we had 200 paleontologists feed in to the science. So the science is great.
Well, I was wondering that about the science, because it's not as if you can just say, oh, we'll just use our imagination here. I mean, it has to be grounded in science. You're not making this up.
No, we used, it's based in science, and we used animals alive today to inform behaviors and, you know, how things would interact to sort of try and tell realistic stories.
I mean, we obviously, there's quite a lot of room for us to make stuff up, to make it look, we want it to look cool at the same time. And, you know, I tease the paleontologists because, you know, there's one particular creature where it changed during the course of the production from, like, thinking it had four toes to five toes. So after that, whenever they said anything to me, I'm like, you don't even know how many toes this thing had. I don't know what you're talking about. And we want to make it look as cool as possible. Yeah, we definitely got that.
You're covering so much ground on not just dinosaurs, of course, but the rise of other reptiles, of invertebrates. You're in the oceans, you're on land. I mean, you're testing every skill you have as visual effects artists.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of stories, there's so many amazing stories. We've all heard of dinosaurs, but the stuff going back through the series is just incredible. Gorgonopsid, which is like a saber-toothed lizard cat, and there's so many amazing stories.
Saber-toothed lizard cat.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, that's not
Thank
science.
Thank goodness they're not around anymore. Are there shots in the series that you think people would be surprised to know they're CGI? Because there were moments I was watching, it's like, I'm not sure if this is CGI or not, which I think is a tribute to the work you're doing.
ILM is part of Disney. We won't mention their name here, but someone there watched the opening of the show, and there's two saber-toothed tigers that are right in the cold open. And this person actually didn't know they weren't real. And they'd been working in the industry for 40 years.
A saber-toothed cat. The Smilodon. A fearsome predator of its age.
That is remarkable. That's eye-opening. You need to send that person over to the La Brea Tar Pits. It might be eye-opening.
Bit of an education needed.
We have some exciting news. Those of you who have been, you know, while we're talking, maybe have checked out deadline.com, but we sent out a bulletin. There's going to be a new iteration of the series. I can't say it's a season two because it's a departure and it doesn't even have a title yet.
It's incredible to be able to tell, I suppose, more in-depth version of the story, and it's gonna be really incredible, this one. I think we're gonna keep, one of the great things about the first one was, it was a dramatization of life on Earth as well as just being the straight story. We tried to, a little bit like Planet Earth 2, we had cold opens and we had tension at the end where you were left hanging to see what happened in the next episode. So I think we're going to do some more of that and have a bit more fun.
Even more fun.
Even more fun.
Even more fun than we had the first time.
And around, Morgan Freeman will be back for that.
How great is it
to see your effects married with his voice?
It's incredible.
Yeah. I mean, it's so great. It really, you know, adds an extra layer to the show. You know, because obviously we spend hours watching it without or with us narrating it, or various people narrating it, and we're not Morgan Freeman, I'll say that. it's incredible. No, his delivery is, and he loves the subject. That was a real surprise. He was totally into it, which none of us really knew. And I think that comes across in his narration, which is superb.
Oh, it absolutely does. It's fantastic.